family, tranquility and affection. All praise is due to Allah, Lord of all worlds, who says in his ever glorious book, it is he who created you all from one soul and from it made its mate so that he might find comfort in her. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his servant and messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him, his household, companions, and upon those who follow their path to the Day of Judgment. Family is the cornerstone of the society and the basis of its structure. The cohesion and stability of a society comes with the cohesion and stability of the family. Therefore, Islam pays great care to the family in order to achieve tranquility, affection, and mercy among all of its members. As the Almighty Allah said, and among his signs is that he created his spouses from among yourselves for you to live with it with in tranquility. He ordained love and kindness between you. There truly are signs in this for those who reflect. When reviewing the verses of the glorious Quran, one finds that the Almighty Allah has shown us that building a family is one of his great signs of his greatness. Allah made marriage a source of tranquility where both spouses resort to one another. Allah made affection and mercy among the foundation of family building. Affection is something that leads to good treatment that both spouses may tolerate the bad thing that the other party may do or the difference of their behaviors. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, a believer must not hate his wife. A believer must not hate his wife. Believing women, if he dislike one of her characteristics, he will be blessed with another. It is in that way the family depends on the meaning of a good manners, good treatment, and compassion. It is in the shadow of the stable and cohesive family, noble quality and good offspring arise, and this promotes happiness in the house. In order to achieve tranquility and affection in the family, certain things must be done, including the good treatment, as the Almighty Allah says, live with them in accordance with what is fair and kind. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, I urge you to act kindly towards women. He, peace be upon him, also said, the best wife is the one whom of her husband look at her, he is blessed. If he commands her, she obeys him. And when she's away from her, and when he's away from her, she guards herself and his wealth. Another thing. If the husband spending on his family by providing it with food, drink, and clothing, as the Almighty Allah says, clothing and maintenance must be borne by the father in a fair manner. And says, let the wealthy man spend according to his wealth. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, the upper hand is better than the lower one. Means the spending hand is better than the receiving hand. And begin charity with those who are under your care. The Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, what a sufficient sin that man neglects those who are under his care. Another point is keeping secret among the two spouses. Very important to keep secret among the two spouses. Both spouses should keep each other's secrets as they are a source of tranquility to one another. To reveal secret is something rejected by religion and good manner. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, the worst of people in a position before Allah on the day of resurrection is the man who intercourse with his wife and she with him and then spread his secrets or spread her secrets. Another thing is cooperation in the process of education children and raising them up in a proper way. The role of the spouses is not only to take care of children by providing food, drink, and marital needs, but also to implant value and moral in their mind in order to quality them to play the role in the advancement and progress of society. In that way, children will be a source of joy of their parent in this world and the hereafter. The Almighty Allah said, "Those who pray, our Lord, give us joy in our spouses and offspring. Make us good examples to those who are aware of you." The Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, "When a man dies, his deed come to an end except for three: continuous charity, knowledge by which people derive benefit, and a pious son who prays for him." As the family pays attention to the right of children, it must pay attention to the right of parents, as the Almighty Allah said, "Your Lord has commanded that you should worship none but him, and that you be kind to your parent." So the security, tranquility, and happiness are achieved for the whole family. Another thing, mutual discussion of life affair of the family, because in this every member of the family feels his role and importance. Once the Prophet, peace be upon him, consulted his wife Umm Salama, may Allah be pleased with her, regarding the Treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah, and she gave him a good opinion. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. May Allah peace and blessing be upon Prophet Muhammad, his companions and followers. There is no doubt that the parent of the two spouses have a great role in maintaining the family and its stability by supporting the bonds of love, respect, and affection between them, respecting their privacy and containing differences by giving advices and guidance to other members of the family. The Almighty Allah says, "Tell my servant to say what is best." Satan saw discord among them. Satan is a sworn enemy of a man. Allah also said, "If you believers fear that a couple may break up, appoint one arbiter from his family and one from hers. Then, if the couple want to put things right, Allah will bring about reconciliation between them. He is all-knowing, all-aware." How much we need to achieve tranquility and affection at our homes. How much we need to achieve tranquility and affection at our homes so that love, harmony, and stability prevail in the whole society. O Allah, give us joy in our spouses and offspring, and make us good example to the pious people. Thank you.